Good morning, Tatiana.
Good morning, Luca.
Thanks for being here in Palazzo Albrizzi-Capello in Venice, opening today Fragmented Identities with your interview. We opened the exhibition today with you, and I'm glad to have you in person here. And we would like to know more about you and your artworks.
Thank you. First of all, also thanks a lot for having me here. I'm so honored to be here. And also would like to thank you for an excellent organization. It's been a pleasure working with you, and so happy to be in Venice again for this wonderful exhibition opening. About my works, here I'm showing one particular series which is called A Tale of Cryptocurrencies. You know, I'm generally interested in kind of in changes in societies in this digital age, because, you know, like we have this new digitalization embedded in our everyday life, and I think it's changing also a lot, you know, the way we interact, the way we live, and probably these changes are going to be even bigger. And this particular series about cryptocurrencies, I started painting it 2 years ago at the height probably of the hype and kind of, you know, speculation wave around Bitcoin. And I thought that was an interesting example of this kind of new digital life. And I wanted to explore in this particular series not only kind of the questions about the hype, but also some broader questions about kind of freedom and its limits, because also we hear a lot that the new digitalization is bringing us additional freedom, etc. Also look at the questions of some ethics, morality, and regulation, sort of, you know, the society between us. And also look at kind of also our new digital identity, which is, you know, which we're developing actually these days.
I have a question about these works particularly. I see that some are more figurative and others are more abstract. The first one, for example, is really more abstract than mm-hmm. the others. Mm-hmm. There is a reason you choose these three artworks and combining one abstract and mm-hmm. two not. Mm-hmm.
I think the series is also developing, you know, it's an ongoing series, and I'm going to continue it. So what you see here is also how the series is developing. Maybe I started more with figurative motifs and trying to express my ideas and feelings this way. And as in life, everything is changing and evolving. And now I see that actually the whole series is becoming more abstract, maybe because I'm also moving towards more kind of broader issues, sometimes more philosophical, which maybe where I need some additional
means of exploration. It's interesting
because of exploration.
Speculation, you represented combining with nature, with
yes.
the environment.
Yes.
And I see in the first painting on the left, this abstract picture seems like a system error of mm-hmm. the computer in which Bitcoin lives.
Yes, yes.
It's, you know, like when the monitor starts to have an error.
Yes, yeah. What you mentioned, old nature, this is actually interesting because another kind of artworks, I do a lot of landscapes and a lot of nature painting. That's another kind of stream of my artwork. But here, even in this series, you see the connection. I find a lot of inspiration in nature and combine it with my kind of thoughts and ideas and feelings in one way. But as you say, yes, indeed, it's sort of developing as I move, you know, to more kind of philosophical questions. Sometimes, yes, it's also changing maybe the way I approach the paintings.
Where do you work usually? Where is your studio? In which city?
I have it actually in Vienna.
Okay.
Yes, I live in Vienna. I have a privilege of working from home. So my home is my office where I do my regular work, and also I have my studio there where I paint.
That's why we said during last week that this strange moment, period, is not affecting so much artists, because artists usually works at home or inside a studio with themselves. So
indeed, that's true. For me, it was not a big change. Exactly. I stayed at home before mostly, and and with the Corona crisis as well. Yeah.
What's your plans for the future? Are you working on some new works?
I do. I mean, I'm certainly going to continue exploring these issues around, our new digital identities, and also maybe a little bit about whether it will really help us to bridge the divide between people, or actually will divide us more in those who are digital, as we say, haves and not haves, those who are kind of can benefit from it better or not. And originally I'm also from Belarus. And you have seen this August has been everywhere in newspapers. There were many articles in Belarus about the frauded elections and the protests of people. And I also have an idea of having quite a big monumental work about August 2020 in Belarus. So hopefully next year we'll be able to show it.
Thank you very much for this interview and for your time, and enjoy the opening.
Thank you so much.